Hey guys, in this video I'm going to share with you the 5 whys method of getting rid of any problem you might have in your life. So if your life is perfect and you don't have any problems, then maybe this video isn't for you. But if you do have problems, and especially if you have problems that don't seem to want to go away, then I think you'll find this really helpful. Most people, if they have a problem in their life or they have something they want to achieve that they haven't been able to achieve, they address the symptoms rather than really the underlying cause of the problem. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to find the actual root cause of the problem so you can begin to address them in a way that's going to actually be effective. And this is a way that's super simple, but hardly anybody knows about it. I got the idea to do this video a few days ago when I was having a conversation with a friend of mine, let's call him George, who was telling me that he had a hard time finding a girlfriend, and the reason why he had a hard time finding a girlfriend was because he was overweight. And so the first thing I thought when I heard that was to tell him, oh, well, you should lose some weight, you should diet and exercise, and I realized that that would be like the most unhelpful thing in the world, because he already knows that, right? Everybody in the world already knows if you want to lose weight, then you have to eat healthier and you have to exercise. So that's really not helpful. So I figured I would use George's story to illustrate this method, what I call the 5 whys method. And I didn't come up with this, by the way, I got it from somewhere else, and I really don't remember where I got it from, so I take no credit for it, but I think it'll be helpful to you, so I'm sharing it. Anyway, so the basic gist of the method is to identify your problem, whatever that is, and then ask why. Why is this problem happening? And ask that 5 times to go 5 levels deep. And so I'll use George's problem to illustrate. So what's the problem? George's problem is that he can't find a girlfriend. Okay, so why can't he find a girlfriend? Well, answer number one, this is the first why. Answer number one is because he's overweight. Okay, now the second why is to ask why to the why. So why is he overweight? Well, probably he's overweight because he doesn't exercise enough and he eats bad. Okay, so now we're 2 whys deep. And most people, this is as deep as they get. They never go past this. So this is where it starts getting interesting. Now you ask, okay, why does he not exercise and why does he eat bad food? And the answer to that question is probably because he lacks the motivation to follow through with an exercise routine or with a diet plan. And I don't know if this is his actual problem, by the way, I'm just kind of speculating here, but I'm showing you how the process works. So these are the questions that George, in his situation, has to ask himself. So the third why was that he lacks the motivation to change his exercise routine and his diet plan. So next we ask the fourth why. Okay, why does he lack motivation? Maybe some part of him subconsciously doesn't want him to get better. Maybe some part of him feels guilty and wants to keep him in that state of unhappiness that he's stuck in. Or maybe he lacks the belief in himself. Maybe he believes that he can never be successful at anything. You see where I'm going with this. The more deep you go, the more fundamental the problems become. And if you can solve those fundamental problems, then that's a lot more useful than trying to solve the surface problems. So if he has a problem with this deep-seated guilt, for example, where he doesn't want himself to be happy, like I talk about in this video, well, addressing that is a lot different than forcing himself to go to the gym. So if you have this self-awareness that you get from going through this exercise, you have radically different solutions to the problem and radically more effective solutions to the problem if you can solve the root problem rather than just the symptom problem. And by the way, the number of levels deep that you go doesn't really matter so much. The point is just to go as deep as you possibly can. So if you get as deep as you can in 4 levels, or maybe you can keep going after 5. I just use 5 as kind of an arbitrary number, but if you can go 10 levels deep, then by all means do it. The deeper you can go, the better. Now, I realize this exercise might be a little bit difficult for some people. It requires some radical honesty. It requires you to look at some pieces of your soul that you might not be so comfortable with. And it requires you to really stop and focus. So, a few tips that I think will help you to do this better. One is to meditate a little while first. Clear your mind, right? Disassociate with your ego a little bit. And then after you meditate, ask for help. Ask the good spirits around you to help reveal these things to you. And even if you don't believe in that hippie spiritual woo-woo stuff like I'm talking about, try it anyway. I mean, just suspend disbelief and I think you'll be pretty surprised at the results. Now let's go through another example just to illustrate again. And for this, I'm gonna use an example from my own life, and that is my shyness that I was horribly shy as a child and still am somewhat, but I've improved a lot in large part thanks to this method. So I'm gonna bare my soul a little bit and go through my 5 whys with you. But first, if you could do me a big favor, please hit the thumbs up icon because it makes the YouTube algorithm like me better. And if you want more content like this in the future, hit the subscribe button and the little bell icon beside the subscribe button so you'll be the first to get all my new videos. Okay, so now the problem that I wanted to address in my own life was that I didn't have the social life that I wanted. I didn't have as many friends. I didn't have as many social opportunities I wanted. And so going through that, the first why was because I was shy. Basically, I was afraid to talk to new people, and if you're afraid to talk to new people, then it's kind of hard to make new friends. So then I asked myself, well, why am I so shy? And I came up with, well, I'm shy because I lack self-confidence. And by the way, if you don't have as much self-confidence as you like to have, you'll find this video helpful. Okay, so why number two was that I lacked self-confidence, and then I had to ask myself, okay, well, why do I lack self-confidence? And confidence is something that's kind of situation-specific, right? So I lack self-confidence when meeting new people, and the reason I came up with that I lack self-confidence when meeting new people is that I did not believe that my presence or my conversation or my attention was valuable enough to merit them spending their time with me. Did not believe that I was worthy of their time. I thought that I was bothering them. And once you get into these deep beliefs, a lot of these are subconscious, by the way. So if you asked me if my time was worthwhile, if I was somebody that people would like to meet, probably I would have said yes, right? Because consciously I believed that I was worthwhile, but subconsciously I had this idea that I was not worthy of other people's time. So going a level deeper, I say, okay, why do I believe that I'm not worthy of other people's time? And the answer I came up with for that was that subconsciously, again, I believe that I am low status and that people don't really want to hang out with somebody who's low status. And then to go one level deeper, I'd ask myself, okay, why do I believe that I'm low status? And the answer was because I feel like I need validation from outside. I need to show that I accomplished something, or I need other people's words of approval to grant me my status as a human being, to grant me my self-worth. If you like this exercise and think it might help you in your own life, I would recommend that you go ahead and try it out now. And if you're really brave, put in the comments, put what your problem is, and put all five levels, or as many levels as you can go, of why. Share in the comments, and I might just address your problem specifically in a future video. And so now I'm five levels deep, and now I understand my problem a whole lot better if I just stuck to the surface and said, oh, well, I'm too shy, I need to go talk to more people. So my solution at that shallow level would be, okay, I'm just going to force myself to talk to people and overcome my shyness, which I did a lot of, by the way. And there's something to be said for that, because at least it makes you, it gives you the confidence that you can overcome your fear and you can do the things you're afraid to do, and there's a lot to be said for that. But that solution, you can see how that's a whole lot different than addressing this really fundamental belief that I have that my sense of worth comes from external sources. And so what I really needed to do on a more fundamental level was to recognize that I am a child of God. I am extremely valuable just for who I am, and that I have been given a sacred mission that nobody else in the world has been given, and I have every capability to fulfill that mission. And you can kind of see through my example why people don't really do this. I mean, one, it's kind of uncomfortable to delve into the dark places in your soul. And two, it kind of forces you to get into deep religious questions. And society, Western society, is deathly afraid of religion. Anything religious, we just shy away from. Nobody wants to talk about it. Nobody wants to address it. And we sure as heck don't want to analyze it in our own lives. But I keep hammering this point. I mean, if you follow me a lot on YouTube, you know I talk about this all the time, how religion is absolutely fundamental to everything you do and everything you achieve and your mental health. So you can ignore it, but your life is going to be very difficult because it's at the root of everything. So if you want to solve your problems, you have to be willing to go to the root of it. And the root of it is, more often than not, something that's going to be kind of uncomfortable. So you have to be willing to do that. And one more note, I also recommend that you don't go blaming past traumas for this stuff. I mean, it's easy to do that, and yeah, a lot of these problems that we have in our lives do have past traumas as the root of them. The only problem is that you can't go back in a time machine and change the past. It just doesn't work. So for my example, for me being shy, I mean, my mom tells me that one day, when I was a kid, I was super outgoing. I always wanted to play with all the other kids, and one day, I went to the park and there was a playground. There were a bunch of kids on the playground. I was all excited to go play with the other kids, and I went and ran over to the playground and got up on the playground. And then some kid who was older than me and didn't want some annoying younger kid playing with him pushed me off the playground. And my mom said from that day forward, I was never the same, right? And now from that day forward, I was kind of afraid of other kids instead of being eager to go play with them. And so, sure, I can point to that incident and say probably that's what caused my subconscious belief, but really, what good does that do? Right, pointing to that incident, identifying the incident that caused it doesn't really help. I mean, it's like going into the chiropractor's office and saying, hey, my back hurts. And the chiropractor asks, okay, well, where did the back pain come from? And you say, oh, I was in a car accident a year ago. And then he tells you to describe the car and describe the scene and describe the accident and tell him how you felt about the accident. And then he says, okay, you can go home now. We've identified the problem. And it's like, well, that doesn't help. My back still hurts. Like, I don't care about what caused the problem, I care about getting rid of the pain. So take my opinion with a grain of salt, because I'm by no means a trained psychologist, but in my opinion, dwelling on bad things that happened to you in the past that caused these problems just isn't going to solve the problem. You have to find some way to change the actual beliefs that you still have today that are causing your problems. Figuring out the nature of the injury is a lot more important, in my opinion, than figuring out how you got it. Anyway, there are a million issues you might want to solve that are at the root of all your problems, and obviously I don't have time to go into all of them right now, but if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon, because I talk about this stuff all the time. But if one of your problems is you don't have enough energy and you'd like to have more energy on a consistent basis, then check out this video where I explain to you exactly how you can do that. And if you found this video helpful and you think it might be helpful to other people too, I'd really appreciate it if you share it.